Hello, my name is Maureen Sullivan, and I'm the Executive Director of the Bedford Chamber of Commerce, and I'd like to welcome you to Chamber Connections. My guest today is Donna Bruno, Chamber Member from UVisualize, and she's going to tell us a lot about the travel industry and her new company. Welcome, Donna.
Thank you very much, Maureen. I appreciate you inviting me.
Oh, no problem. You're going to be a great guest. So, let's start with your company. Tell me a little bit about it.
UVisualize is a travel consulting firm and technically based in Needham, but I have so many connections in Bedford that I had to be a Bedford Chamber member. We're about 2 years old, and we specialize in customizing itineraries for folks.
Cool. And are you, before I ask you about your company, I like to ask a little about how you got into it. Like, is your background in travel? You love to travel?
Well, I love to travel. I've been from Alaska to Australia, and I was in the hospitality business for 20 years and in corporate travel management for about six. And I left it for a few years to go into the senior industry, but I missed it terribly and I had to go back. So actually my brother and I decided to do it ourselves.
That's great. All right, so let's start. So tell me how the travel industry, I mean, I know in my own little, small traveling world that I do, how it's changed over the last, 15, 20 years.
Dramatically. Used to be that everyone had a travel agent. Mm-hmm. And then all of these sites started popping up online where people said, well, why do I need a travel agent? I'm going to go and do it myself, which still occurs today. But what we found in the last few years, Maureen, is that the pendulum is starting to swing in the other direction again, that there's so much information available online that people are becoming overwhelmed. And they just don't have time to spend the hours of research required to book the kind of trip that they want.
So with the internet, so you do when versus just the flight I'm going to take to, go down and see my mother in Florida, your clients are looking for the full experience. Like, I want to go
exactly.
to Europe. I
exactly.
call you up and say, and so not only do you just, what, like if I called you and said, okay, I want to take a trip to Paris, walk me through the steps of, what you would do and what you would suggest or...
Very good. What we would do is we would sit down with you, mm-hmm. and we would get to know you. What do you like? What do you consider fun? What do you want to do? What's on your bucket list? What kinds of trips have you taken in the past? So we really get a good idea of what's going to be a memorable experience for you. And then we start doing research based on your ideal location as to what kinds of places there are to stay that meet your criteria and what you might like to do. So we actually will develop daily itineraries, museums, restaurants, cultural events, all different kinds of activities.
Well, so you really, you're not going to find that on the internet.
No, when we provide weather tables and shopping suggestions and actually book museum tickets and the whole nine yards for you.
So, okay, so most online sites don't have those services, but do you compete, are there any, like, what do you compete with on the online?
We don't really. If someone comes to us and says, well, Donna, can you find us the best deal for spring break in Florida? So, you know what, have you tried some of the online sites? Because that's really not what we do.
Right.
We really create bespoke experiences for folks. And we're not going to be able to find you the best possible deal.
Right.
Because prices are changing all the time. We really create experiences. So if you just wanted to go to Florida for the weekend, then I would probably suggest, we certainly, if you want to hire us to book the airline ticket
right.
for you, we'll certainly do that. But you're going to get the best deal if you do the homework yourself online. People hire us to create experiences for them.
So tell me, how does a travel... I guess, are you called the consultant now, or you're not really a travel agent? Because in the past, people really didn't do that, or maybe a high-end,
Right,
customer.
Exactly.
But where a lot of people now do that, they, they're like you said, they get their bucket list. How does a travel consultant get paid?
A few different ways. Airlines do not pay commissions anymore. And they used to, many years ago,
wow.
Yes. And that's when airlines stopped paying commissions, that's when you first started to see the travel agents reduce in number. And then with the online booking tools, then really, they really were almost extinct for a little while. But so airlines don't pay commissions. Hotels will often pay commissions, but it depends on the rate. And there are many places like bed and breakfast that don't pay commissions.
Mm-hmm.
Cruise lines will typically pay commissions. Tour operators will typically pay commissions. So we, in order to create the kind of experiences we do for our clients, we charge a consulting fee. And then if we make a little bit of commission on top of that, great.
Okay, so it's like you charge an hourly rate or?
Typically it's per trip. If, for example, if you want, you said you wanted to go to Europe for 2 weeks and you've never been to Paris and you want us to create a 2-week itinerary for Paris, we would charge a $750 flat fee and we would customize it daily itinerary for you. For
wow,
that trip.
That's pretty affordable.
I think so.
You're spending all this money, so anyway, so you might as well get what you want when you get there.
Right.
All right, so let's move on to how about with companies and like group trips? You do that as well?
Yes. As a matter of fact, right now we're working on a group trip. It's corporate executives are having a little retreat. They're renting a couple of villas, and we're coordinating everything, the private chef, the golf tee times, everything for them.
Wow, can I go work for that company?
I know. Yes.
And
really
where are they going?
They're actually going to one of the islands.
Nice, very nice. Now, you're just started your business, although you've done some traveling yourself. So when you have to create this experience in an island that you haven't been to, how do you
manage
that?
I actually have been there, but
let's say you were going to an island you hadn't been to.
Then we do a lot of research.
Right.
We have sort of industry partners we can call, and my partner specifically is tremendous with the actual research, and that's what takes the time, and that's what's worth the money, because a lot of our clients they don't have the hours to spend vetting out these places on their own.
That's awesome.
For example, this group client, they gave us some criteria. They were overwhelmed, trying to figure out where can we go nonstop from Boston where we can play golf for
that's
a long weekend.
Being a golfer, that is not an easy that's not an easy charge, because that would be something that I have researched, because I'm not a big flyer, but I am a big golfer. And so I don't want to go any place where I have to go up and down more than once.
And as they started to try to do this on their own, they realized they were spending an inordinate amount of time just trying to find nonstop flights to warm places. So they finally said, help, we can't do this anymore.
That's awesome.
So we researched a handful of locations for them, nonstop flights, and said, here are all the options. And then we narrowed it down based on the right.
And then they go.
Yep.
So when you see, as far as travel agents, now when you are a travel consultant, travel agent, do you yourself, just in case anyone wants to go into the business and they love to travel, like I know, like if you work for the airlines, you get cuts and, you know, you get free flying. Do you get, you know, perks or benefits for being a travel consultant?
You do, yes. Not the way it used to be. I used to get some really wonderful deals when I was in the travel business a number of years ago. Not so much anymore, but yes, we still can get some pretty good deals if they have availability.
So I just want to go back quickly to the airline. So did the airline stop giving commissions because of the internet presence, or did the internet presence become because they stopped giving commissions?
Oh,
do you know?
Which came first? I think it was a combination.
Right.
As the fuel prices started to increase and the online tools started to become more prevalent, they realized that they just didn't have to.
Right. Because people could just do it themselves.
Right, or call the airline directly, even before the online booking tours.
So when is the best time to travel?
Depends on what you want to do.
Really? Like there are days, months, it depends where you're going.
Right.
How about on a specific day? Is there, like, as I said, on a travel neophyte? You know, is it better to go on a, is it cheaper to go on a Wednesday? Or you really
It can
don't...
be. It depends on the location. It depends on supply, really supply and demand. Mm-hmm. So if you're going to Alaska in August, it's going to be more expensive than if you go in February. So it really depends. I've read lots of articles that say it's less expensive to travel midweek and make sure you have a Saturday night stay and all those kinds of things. But I haven't found them to always be true.
Me too. So how is it working with your brother? Having four brothers, I like to find out how somebody, with their siblings.
Am I blushing? Oh, dear. Because we used to fight like cats and dogs when we were growing up. But now our skill sets really complement each other. Mm-hmm. I'm more of the front of the house with sales and marketing, and he is the back of the house, all the operational things and the research. And so it's a really good combination. If you had told me 20 years ago, I would have said, nope, no way.
That's great. That's great. Well, so let's just talk a little bit about your chamber experience, because this is a chamber show. And as you said, I first met you when you were working with the seniors, which I'm sure you miss. So tell me what you like about the chamber, or you know, why you came back to Bedford.
And I actually lived in Bedford when I was about three. I don't know if that counts.
Really? I didn't know that.
Yes. But I found this community to be very welcoming, very friendly. I got to know people quickly. Mm-hmm. And it's a small knit community, and I found that I really missed that.
Right, right. So here, you know, obviously I advertise for you in the Bedford Chamber, but where else do you put your name out there? Like, do you have a, you know, you're obviously on the web, but
we are, yes.
And where's your business coming from? Is it coming online? Or is
no,
it coming
it's coming from word of mouth.
Right,
right. Direct contacts.
Well, I'm sure if you plan one great trip for someone, then you're going to get lots of.
That's the idea. That's the idea. And that's why I'm really trying to be as involved as I can be with the chamber, because it's meeting more people, mm-hmm. having people get to know you, and they feel comfortable with you, and they trust you, and they'll ask you for advice.
Well, if we ever plan a trip, then we know.
Especially golf,
to go.
Right.
Yes, yes, yes. We just get to go down to the Patriot Golf Course, which is, you know, down Springs Road. It's not a bad haul. Well, I think this is great. I know when you went into the field, you were excited about it, and I'm so happy to see that you're doing well. And your information is, you want to tell the camera, you can tell what the name of your company is and your website and how to get in contact with you.
Certainly. It's You Visualize, and it's U, the letter U, VISUALIZE.com.
Great. Well, thanks for coming, Donna.
Thank
and
you so much,
Maureen.
And
when I want to go west, or warm and golf. You're the girl I call.
Thank you so much for having me.
Take care.